Good afternoon, everyone. Today, we'll discuss a very common thing that we see on routine endoscopies, that is called as the gastric polyps. Now, in the stomach, whenever we find any mucosal excrescences, and they are being termed as mucosal outgrowths or the gastric polyps. Now, it's a very common finding. Its prevalence ranges from 0.8 to 2.4%. Again, this data is from the various endoscopic studies, because they are very small. We cannot look these polyps in most of the CT scans or the MRI. These polyps are mostly asymptomatic, and whenever we do a routine endoscopy, especially in elderly people, we find presence of these polyps. Now, if we classify them, then broadly we have three variants: the fundic gland polyps, the hyperplastic, and the adenomatous polyps. Most common are the fundic gland ones, which are commonly seen in the region of fundus. Hyperplastic polyps are very common with H. pylori infection, and whenever we have very small polyps in our stomach, then in these patients we should do resection and send them for histology. If there are polyps which are sizes more than 1 centimeter, then it should undergo a polypectomy. And after excision of these polyps, if there are multiple, then we should try to excise as many as possible, keeping in mind the risk of bleeding, perforation, and send biopsies. In addition to biopsy, to take biopsy from these polyps, it is important to biopsy the enteral and the corpus mucosa, because coexistence of dysplasias and H. pylori infection can occur. H. pylori eradication, as you all know, it's a commensal bacteria in our stomach, and it is linked to occurrence of gastric ulcers, dysplasias, GI malignancies, gastric lymphoma, and even these polyps. So we try to eradicate this H. pylori infection as our treatment modality. We commonly use drugs like amoxicillin, metronidazole, clarithromycin, bismuth citrate, together with that the combination of PPIs. So coming into detail of these polyps, fundic gland polyps are the most common. They are mostly benign. A lot of people who are chronic users of proton pump inhibitors, they develop. The risk of malignancy is very low. It is less than 1%. And the familial adenomatous polyposis, the disease which affects the colon, there also the fundic gland polyps are there. But then, because of the genetic preponderance, there is higher risk of dysplasia and malignancy. Polyps which are larger, they need to be resected and being followed thereby. If we have patients with hyperplastic polyp, again, they are also benign, they are multiple. They are very common in patients who are elderly, who are adult, and the chronic inflammatory conditions like chronic atrophic gastritis, pernicious anemia, and wherever we have ulcers in the stomach because of the reflux, whenever there is ulcer, the body tries to compensate, there is a lot of healing, and that lead to development of these hyperplastic polyp. Whenever we find these polyps, they need to be resected. There has to be a surveillance endoscopy, and the H. pylori eradication is recommended. When it comes to adenomatous polyps, they have the highest risk of malignant transformation. Chances of progression from dysplasia to carcinoma is around 11%. Again, H. pylori eradication is indicated. So this is an algorithm from the journal, American Journal of Gastroenterology, which shows that how should we deal with these gastric polyps. So after taking a biopsy, we classify them into the three variants that we talked about. We go on for eradicating H. pylori, and we do a surveillance endoscopy every year. So this is the way by which we should move forward. Another common thing that when we discuss the gastric polyp, their resection, an important thing I want to cover in this short lecture is about early gastric cancer. Now the thing is that the polyps and the development of atrophic gastritis, pernicious anemia, they all ultimately have chances to develop into gastric malignancy. If we diagnose it late, the advanced gastric cancer have very high mortality, and there are limited options whether we call it of chemotherapy or surgery. So it's better to identify it early in the form of early gastric cancer. Now this is the Paris classification, where we look at the protruding, pedunculated, and sessile variants, The most common variant being the 2C variant, which is slightly depressed malignancy, and then we have the type 3 variants. Now it's important to diagnose it early before the lymph nodal spread has occurred, so that we can go for endoscopic resection, endoscopic surgery. The endoscopic ultrasound is the modality to understand the depth of invasion of gastric polyps. So if this, you look at the basics of this EUS, now this is a transducer, and in this we can look at the five layers of the stomach. Now this is the layer called mucosa, then there's muscularis mucosae, then another hyperechoic layer, submucosa, muscularis propria and serosa. So depending upon the appearance of the early, we have to do this for polyps as well, whenever we have sessile polyps, as well as for the growths, and we look at the depth of invasion. Depending upon the depth of invasion and the size of the tumor, we go for EMR and ESD. The same thing apply for early gastric cancer as well as for the polyps, because we cannot do for pedunculated polyps, you can go for snare polypectomy. But when you are confronted with the sessile polyps that are again a common finding, we have to do either EMR or ESD. Now if you look at the EMR, there is criteria that a lesion has to be type 2C, it should be less than 1 centimeter, it should be located in the mucosa, no lymph node involvement, and intestinal type 1 biopsy. Then we can inject some amount of fluid in the base of these polyps and we can remove them with the forceps. This is what is called endoscopic mucosal resection. Another thing is endoscopic submucosal dissection. So we are just coming to an end of this small lecture of gastric polyps and their management. So one way of management is to go for H. pylori treatment and regular surveillance. Second thing is for pedunculated, do polypectomy. For sessile, we do EMR, and this is called ESD, endoscopic submucosal dissection. So it is a way to achieve R0 resections even for early gastric cancer. The main risk is of bleeding and perforation. And the criteria is that if we have intestinal type early gastric cancer of less than 3 cm, or submucosal invasion should be less than 500 microns, which has to be decided by endoscopic ultrasound. So these are the modalities called EMR and ESD and polypectomy, by which endoscopically we deals with the gastric polyps and the early gastric cancer. If we have a patient with gastric cancer which has advanced beyond these criterias, then the surgery is the only way to deal with. Thank you.